Welcome friends, my name is Pratik Sharma. I am assistant professor in the Global Institute of Technology, Jaipur, in Department of Civil Engineering. Subject name is Hydraulic Engineering. Topic name is Open Channel Flow. Subject code is 4CE406. So here we understand the basic concept of open channel flow. So here is the presentation is outline of presentation. So what is open channel? What are the types of flows discharged through open channel and most economical section? So what is open channel? Open channel flow is a flow which has a free surface and flows due to gravity. So here is the word free surface. Means constant atmospheric pressure act on water surface, or you can say a free surface is a surface having constant pressure such as atmospheric pressure act on water surface. The second point is pipe not flowing full also fall into the category of open channel flow. Means most of the cases in pipe, if diameter is large, if pipe fill water with half of depth, means atmospheric pressure also act. And in third point, in open channel the flow is driven by the slope of the channel rather than the pressure. So the word is slope of the channel means difference in the difference in section. Next slide is types of flows. Steady and unsteady flow, uniform and non-uniform flow, laminar and turbulent flow, subcritical, critical and supercritical flow. So we understand one by one. So what is steady and unsteady flow? Steady flow happens if the conditions, flow rate, velocity, depth, etc. do not change with time. Means these are the flow parameters and it doesn't change with the time, that flow is called steady flow. And what is unsteady flow? The flow is unsteady if the depth is changes with time. So that flow is called unsteady flow and the depth is changed with time. And next slide is uniform and non-uniform flow. If for a given length of channel the velocity of flow, depth of flow, slope of the channel and cross section remain constant, the flow is said to be uniform flow. Means these are remain constant, these properties are constant, doesn't change. And the flow is non-uniform if velocity, depth, slope and cross section is not constant. So this flow is called non-uniform flow. There is this basic difference between uniform and non-uniform flow. And further we classify non-uniform flow. Two types of non-uniform flow, gradually varied flow and rapidly varied flow. What is gradually varied flow? Abbreviation is GVF. If the depth of the flow in a channel changes gradually over a length of the channel. That is called gradually varied flow. And rapidly varied flow, if the depth of the flow in the channel changes abruptly over a small length of channel. Means suddenly change. And third flow is laminar and turbulent flow. Both laminar and turbulent flow can occur in open channel depending on the Reynolds number. We all know what is Reynolds number. Reynolds number is represented by Re equal to R equal to rho Vr by mu, where rho is density of water, 1000 kg per meter cube, mu is dynamic viscosity, R capital R is hydraulic mean depth equal to area upon weighted parameter. This is a diagram of turbulent flow, laminar flow. In turbulent flow, the flow is not in straight path, particle flow in zigzag pattern. Laminar flow, its flow is a straight path, that is called laminar flow. So what difference between laminar flow transmission depend upon the Reynolds number. So R equal to rho Vr upon mu. Although V is the average velocity of the fluid, R is the hydraulic radius of the channel. So what is laminar flow? If the Reynolds number value is less than 500, that flow is called laminar flow. What is transitional flow? If Reynolds number value is between 500 to 1000, that flow is called sorry 1000, that flow is called transitional flow, and turbulent flow is greater than, and the Reynolds number value is greater than 1000, that flow is called turbulent flow. So now is subcritical, critical and supercritical flow. What is this? The flow in open channel is said to be subcritical if the Froude number is less than 1. What is Froude number? Froude number is represented by Fe equal to V upon rho g d, here V equal to mean velocity of flow, d is hydraulic depth of channel, and is equal to the ratio of weighted area to the top width of channel equal to A by T, where T equal to top width of channel. Subcritical flow is also called triangle or streaming flow or subcritical flow when Fe is less than 1. When the Froude number is value is less than 1, that flow is called subcritical flow or triangle flow or streaming flow. The flow is critical, it's called critical if Froude number is equal to 1, and if Froude number is greater than 1, the flow is called supercritical, shooting rapid or torrential flow. So these are the basic difference between subcritical, critical and supercritical, depends upon Froude numbers. The next point is geometric properties of open channel. Geometric properties of open channel, here you can see type of channel is shape, rectangular, top width of rectangular is capital P, area is BY, and weighted parameter is B plus 2Y, same in trapezoidal, top width is B plus 2MY, area is BY plus MY square, weighted parameter B plus 2Y enter 1 plus M square. So discharge through open channel by different formula, Sayce's, Manning's and Benzin's formula, Cutter's formula. So next slide is most economical section. So cost of construction should be minimum, discharge should be minimum. Means most economical section means when we get maximum discharge, or where we find the value of maximum discharge. So cost of construction depends on minimum value of parameter. If perimeter more, material requirement more, hence cost of construction maximum. So that section we choose, if the discharge in maximum, construction cost is less. So types of channel based on shape, rectangular, trapezoidal and circular. So what is rectangular section? Here you can see for most economical section P should be minimum. We differentiate the parameter with respect to D equal to 0. Here you can see diagram of rectangular, width is B and depth is D. So area, we all know B into D. So B equal to A by D is equation 1. Get the value of again parameter P plus 2D. A by D plus 2D is equal to, is equation number second. For most economical section P should be minimum. Again we differentiate parameter with respect to D. Here we get the value of P is 2D and D equal to P by 2. And finally we get the value of M equal to A by P equal to B into D upon B plus 2D equal to 2D square upon 2D plus 2D by equal to by D by 2. So we find the value of parameter. Again in trapezoidal section, width is B, depth is D. For most economical section P should be minimum. Differentiate the parameter with respect to D. Area is B plus Handley into D. This is equation 1, and second equation, getting the value of parameter and differentiate with respect to D, and you get the value of M equal to D by 2 and theta equal to 60 degrees. So this is the basic idea of open channel flow. So thanks.